Hello, madam. Now, I'm going to show the demo part of our system MTRS. For your information, madam, I cannot show the error checking of our system due to the time constraint. Sorry about it, madam, but I will explain about every element we have included in our system. First, I'm going to show the demo part of the customer's portion. So, the user must enter A in order to proceed to the customer's portion. The system is now only have 5 movies because the cinemas right now is only providing 5 movies. So let's say the user wants to select the Lost World movie. So the user have to select the serial number of the movie, which is 2. After selecting 2, the system will show or will aware the user that he have selected the correct movie, Lost World. After selecting it, the user have to select Showtime 1, Showtime 2, Showtime 3, because there is 3 showtime for each movies available in the cinemas. So the user have to select 1, 2, or 3 in order to select the showtime. Let's see, for example, now I'm selecting Showtime 2. After selecting the showtime, if the user feels that I have selected the wrong movie, so he can reselect the movie by selecting R. He can reselect. Now I can gonna select Avengers, which is the serial number is 1. After that, I can select the showtime, another showtime here. Now I'm gonna select the showtime 3. Then I can wish to go back to the main screen because there will be some users, they will be exploring how the system works. So they can select B just to go back to the main screen. They can go back. So let's see, we're gonna see about what it meant by proceed. Proceed means that they can proceed to the seat selection after selecting P. We can go to the seat selection. We have divided the seats into rows and columns. So the user, let's say they're going to select B5. He or she must enter the row first. So the row is B. The user have to enter B. And then the column is 5. So the user have to enter 5. After selecting the 5, the user will be prompted that they have selected B5. After they have been prompted, they have to select 2 seat types because this cinema is providing 2 seat types, which is deluxe and normal. So if the user does not have the knowledge about what is meant by deluxe and normal, they can select Y to get more information about deluxe seats and normal seats. But if they have been familiar with these cinemas and they know what is deluxe seat and normal seat, they can enter just N. After selecting the N or Y, they will be prompted to select the seat type, which is A or B, which is the selection for deluxe and also the normal. Let's say for this example, I'm selecting the deluxe seat, which is A. After selecting the seat type, the user must enter the name. After entering the name, they can enter the phone number. After selecting the phone number, they will be again prompted to select back, proceed, or reselect. This is something like what we have done with the selection movie. So the user who wish to go to the receipt part, they can enter P. After selecting P, it will show the seat selected, the price for this seat, the amount to pay, and then the cash you're gonna enter. If you enter the cash, which is less than the amount to pay, let's say for example 15, you will be shown that you have entered an insufficient amount to pay. So enter again. You must enter amount of money which is more than the amount to pay. So now I'm entering 20 ringgit. The system will show the change, which is 2 ringgit, and then thank you message. Then you can enter Y or N. Y if you wish to purchase another seat, and N if you have done with the system. Now I have done with the customer part. So I will enter N. Ta-da, finished. So now we're gonna look into the management part of our system. So I must enter B in order to proceed to management's portion, B. So we have been set a username password system in order to go to the management, because this management, we can add movie, delete movie, and update the showtime for these movies in these cinemas. So we have included the username and password for the management person. For me, now our system have 5 usernames and password, which is our group members. For me, I have a username. And for my group members, they have their individual usernames. For me, my username is Madhavan and password is MTRS. If the password is correct, we can proceed to the management's portion, which is to add movie, delete movie, and update movie. Let's say my password is wrong. Let's say I am MTRQ. So it will show invalid login attempt. We show until 5 login attempts. If it proceeds 5 login attempts, the system will close automatically. So now I will gonna enter correct username, correct password in order to enter to the system. Enter movie, update the showtime, and delete movie. First, I want to enter a new movie into the system. So what I will do, I will enter 1. So now what I must do is, I must enter the name of the movie, let's say Popeye, and the time for the first showtime. For example, 1500, 1600, and now the part is here is that if the manager or the user of the system enters a time wrongly, let's say he enters alphabet instead of numbers for the time, the system will show enter a valid time, because time means we should enter numbers, not alphabets. So if we enter alphabets, the system will show an error message, enter a valid time. So what we must do is, we must enter a correct time where, for example, 1700. Then it will show you have done, manager. We actually have done adding a new movie into the system. So if you want to see into the update, the movie showtime, we're going to enter into second part. After entering 2, now what we can do is we can edit the showtime for every movie in this system. Before that, we can see that the movie we have added is in the cinemas now. So for the editing the movie time, I'm going to select the movie Avengers. So I must enter 1. After entering 1, will again aware that you have selected Avengers. So for the first showtime, what I will do is I will enter. Okay, I'm going to enter another time, which is 1500. Then second one, let's say 1800. And then 1700, for example. Okay, we have done editing the time here. So if I go to the main page again, and I want to delete the movie, means I will select 3. And then you can see here that we have edited the showtime of movie Avengers. So now what we're going to do is that we're going to delete a movie in the system. So for example, what I'm going to do is that now I'm going to delete this movie Last Man. Last Man with the serial number of 4. So what I will do is I will enter 4. After that, done. Yeah, we have done editing the movie Last Man. So if I go again, select 3 to delete a movie, we cannot see the movie Last Man in the cinemas. Thank you.